like Harry Shotta, you know. It's nice to have you in the building.
What's going on?
5 years of ArsenalFanTV. What's your thoughts on the channel, first of all?
The channel, man. I remember when I first copped onto the channel, I think it was through Ty and Claude. It just popped up on the timeline. I was like, rah, this is entertaining. As much as I'm like the biggest gooner in the world, you know what I'm saying? It's the way they were bouncing off each other and whatnot. And then I dig deeper into it and I saw people like DT and Troops. And then I started thinking, you know what? When I finish a match sometimes, these two's kind of represent how I feel. It's like on Sunday after that madness, like I felt a way about it. I don't normally watch when we lose. That takes me a couple of days. I'm a bit like that. I feel the pain, do you know what I mean? But like I watched it and I was like, what DT and Troop said, it exemplified how I felt about the game and about the situation, about the club currently. So yeah, man, definitely. Like ArsenalFanTV, I've been on it for a minute now. I probably clocked onto it about 2 years in.
Okay.
And now it's like five years.
Crazy five how much years. It's grown. I mean, it's a dire time to be an Arsenal fan at the moment because we're not doing much. But what do you feel like we can achieve within, like, if not this season, within like the next 5 years?
I think Arsenal as a club, on the day we can do what we do. You know, I was at the Tottenham game and we done that. We done the thing, like we dealt with what we had to do. And other times we just roll over. You know what I mean? We just roll over. No one's got no energy on the pitch. No one's got no vibes. You know what I mean? It's like, it's a bit of a cliche to say it's the manager, but me personally, I think it's time to go. It is the manager. We need someone else to come in fresh, boost these players up. And we signed people like Aubameyang, you know what I mean? That was, for me, that was massive to get a player of that quality coming into our side. I couldn't even believe it.
Me too, to be honest.
I couldn't believe it. That, even, you know, the Jack, the plug.
Yeah.
He was all saying to me, he was DMing me, because I'm like, he ain't coming.
Yeah, he was confident, like, yeah, cocksure, yeah. That he's definitely
super
coming.
Confident, and he makes a lot of right predictions. Yeah. So I think, we you know, we had a good transfer window. Sanchez had to go, even though I was the biggest Sanchez fan. If you don't want to be here, no player is bigger than this club. No player, no manager, nobody is bigger than the badge, do you know what I mean? So, me personally, Sanchez, see you later, Mkhitaryan, welcome. Aubameyang, welcome, you know what I mean? And let's just build, and like, I have to be positive. Like, I'm not like delusional, but I always have to keep a positive mind state.
Even though, do you feel like these players can flourish under Wenger?
These players under Wenger? You know what, yeah, respect for the past to Arsene and everything he's done, respect for the Invincibles, respect for, you know, all these things he's done in the past, but right now, it's gone. It's dead. Like, I can't do Sunday anymore. I'm leaving WhatsApp groups with mates of mine.
Yeah, I've left all of them.
I'm leaving because I can't. It's like I can't take the banter anymore because I don't. We're not a joke team. We're a big club, and we need to start acting like one. And as much as I respect the past and everything else, Wenger has to go, man. Straight up and down. And it's like that is the one undeniable factor. I know, and people get romantic about Wenger, innit? They get all romantic and like, and they'll have no criticism about the guy. It took me a while. Them lot will tell you that Troops and DT have corrupted me.
Have they?
They'll tell you that Troops and DT have corrupted me, but it's not even that. It's the results on the pitch that have made me change. And like, you know, I was like a silent Wenger out guy for a while, but I just wouldn't be outwardly public with it out of respect. But you know what, over the last two seasons, I just had to come out and just be real.
And you're done, you're done.
That's what I said, the club, the badge is bigger than any manager, any player. And I'm just done with it now, do you know what I mean? It's like, it's a madness.
On a positive note, it's good to have you here though.
Yeah, it's good, man.
I would love to ask you, like, who is your, I know you mentioned Claude and Ty and Troops everyone, but like, what's been your highlight of ArsenalFanTV?
My highlight? Well, there's so many, you know. Sometimes, I like it when we win. So I actually think my highlight, yeah, was when we beat Chelsea 3-0 last season, and Troops and them man started singing the Mesut Ozil song, because I love Ozil, you know. I love Ozil, that's my guy, do you know what I mean? So when them lads started singing the song, I watched every video, I was gassed in my yard. I didn't even need a drink, I was just gassed off the videos, do you know what I mean? So yeah, I think that was a big one for me when Troops is one. I mean, there's been other ones I've agreed with where I've been annoyed and whatnot, but the ones I like are the ones when we win.
Yeah.
And we
that's
can
what
enjoy
we want
it.
To see.
And we can enjoy it and celebrate and everything else, do you know what I mean? So that's actually probably my favourite ArsenalFanTV video, when Troops was celebrating and everyone started singing the Ozil song and whatnot. That was a big moment, man. Because we didn't beat Chelsea for a long time before that. And I've been there. I went to the game when Chelsea was shit that season. Dire. And we was all like, I was drinking from early, out in the pubs, up and down. Went to the match and we lost. And you know what I mean? So for me, beating Chelsea was a big thing, 100%.
Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
Hope you enjoy the rest of the evening.
Yeah. Take care. Big respect, yeah?